Today's class, we are going to be looking at hands of government. Every level of the Nigeria government is divided into the organs of government. They are the legislature, the legislative, the executive, and the judicial. It's the legislative. Is the arm of government which makes the law that governs both the people and the government. The legislature is the organ of government which makes the law that governs the people and the government. At the federal level, the legislature is called the National Assembly. That assembly, it is into two areas. It has the Senate and the House of Representatives. Each state has representative in the National Assembly. Every representative comes from a zone in the state. The bigger the state, the more of the representative it will have. Every state has at least one representative elected by the citizen of the state. There are 360 members of the House of Representatives. The head of the House of Representatives is the Speaker of the House. Members of the Senate are called senators. There are 109 senators. Each state has 3 senators who are elected by the people of the state. The head of the Senate is called the Senate President. When the National Assembly wants to make a law, both the House of Representatives and the Senate have to agree on the law. At the state level, there is a State House of Assembly, just as we have in Edo State, located at Ring Road. That's our House of Assembly. While at the local government level, the council members, we have the National House of what? Assembly. Then now, the second one is the executive, which is the second arm of government. The executive, they sees to the day-to-day running of the government. It enforces the law and carries out government policies. At the federal level, the president is the head. Other members of the executive are the president's cabinet, which include the vice president, ministers, and the special advisor to the executive. So in Nigeria, those that make up the executive members are the president of Nigeria, which is Muhammadu Buhari. Then we have Osibanjo, which is also what? Members of that cabinet. While the state executive is the state governor, the deputy governor, and commissioners, just as we have in Edo State, Godwin Obaseki is the state executive, then Shaibu and commissioners are the state executive. Then at the local government level, the executive refers to the chairman of the local government council and the members of the local council. Then the third part of the government, which interprets the laws of the courts and punishes people who break them. The judiciary upholds the constitution. They protect the people and the government. At the federal level, the judiciary consists of the Supreme Court. The Supreme Court is the highest court in the country. A member of the Supreme Court is called a justice. We have 21 justices in Nigeria Supreme Court. The head of the Supreme Court is the Chief Justice. The federal judiciary also consists of the Federal High Court and the Federal Court of Appeal. At the state level, the judiciary consists of the state high court, the state high court of appeal, and the magistrate's court. While at the local level, there are customary courts. The customary courts are the lowest courts in Nigeria. In northern Nigeria, this includes the Shara courts. Then the next thing the three arms of government are built on a system of check and balance. This system ensures that no arm of government, whether it's the executive, the judiciary, the legislature, no arm of government becomes too powerful. Each arm of the government is to be checked. I'm not saying because you are the executive, they will not check you, or because you are under the judiciary, they will not check you. They are being checked. And each arm of the government is checked by two other in different ways. For example, the president can veto a law passed by the National Assembly. However, the National Assembly can override that veto with a vote of 2/3 of both the House of Representatives and the Senate. The Supreme Court can check the National Assembly by declaring a law unconstitutional. Members of the Supreme Court are appointed by the president, but all these choices have to be approved by the National Assembly. So checks and balance within the government are very important. They help to ensure that no arm of government abuses the power that has been given to them. That way, our government will be fair and what? Just. How is this We have the federal level, the executive under the federal level are the president, the vice president, and the minister. Then under the legislature, we have the state house of assembly, senate, and the house of representatives, just as I created the table there. Then the judiciary also, in the federal level, we have the supreme, the court level, the court of appeal. So just as it is there, that is how the government is organized on that table over there. There must be cooperation between the local, the state, and the federal government. Cooperation among the different levels of government is very important because it ensures that all the affairs of the country runs smoothly. When the different levels of government cooperate successfully, the country becomes better for everyone. The state and the local government receive grants from the federal government to run their affairs, while the local states and the federal work together by making and enforcing laws that deal with crime. So the local state and federal government work together to provide basic services that their people need. So finally, this lesson is letting us know that each level of the Nigerian government is divided into three arms, which are called the organs of the government. These three arms, legislative, the judiciary, and the legislature. The executive enforces the laws and carries out the law of the country. The legislative arm of government makes the law, while the judiciary, they interpret that law and punish any one of us who break them. All arms of government are built on a system of check and balance, cooperation. Cooperation among the different levels of government is very important because this will ensure that all the affairs of the country run smoothly, and it brings together the country that they are in charge of would be the best among See you in our next class.